Hi, we are here at the London Independent Film Festival 2018, and this is Sue Clayton, who directed a film called Calais Children, A Case to Answer, and it's a wonderful documentary. So tell us a bit more about the film, Sue.
Hi, well, thanks for having me. Basically, I went to the Calais jungle before it was pulled down by the French, and I couldn't believe the fact that mixed up with all the adults and all the craziness and the tear gassing and the violence, there was nearly 2,000 unaccompanied kids. And I couldn't believe, because there are no government people there, there are no NGOs there. These kids were just having to survive on their own, and the camp was about to be pulled down. But then I discovered they actually had a legal right to be in the UK, but no one would listen. So that's why it was a really important film to make.
Great. So has the film had any reaction then as a documentary of that nature?
Well, we've used it as a campaign tool. So this is actually the 101st screening. So we're kind of getting into party mode because we hit 100. So it's been used to all over Europe as a campaign film. But the thing I'm really proud of is I managed to get 14 lawyers, human rights lawyers, out to the jungle for nothing. We took on a whole batch of the most vulnerable kids as clients, and we've battled and battled and battled in court to get all the children accepted for the UK with this group as, like, you know, the first group. And we kept getting refused. We went the first court, we lost. The next level, we lost. The next level. So then we went right up to the High Court and did a judicial review where we accused the Home Office of acting unlawfully. And you can't often in your life say, I sued the government. So I'm just saying it. I sued the government. Because I can't be more proud. And the film is the actual, my witness statement is my film. And we still don't know if we've won. We went to court for 3 days last month. But I think we've got to these days, you know, you can't just let these things go by and go, well, that's a shame, send them a sleeping bag or something. You have to actually say to the people making the decisions, you know, there's a law here and you're not using it. So, oh, can't wait to know if we win.
You've got a good cause.
Yeah.
So other than waiting to hear if you've won, what else is next?
Yeah, well, I also do drama. I do fiction as well. And it's partly written. I'm writing a thriller because the other thing that Britain does is when these kids, the ones we do accept, reach 18, they're, what do you call them, G4S, and all these private security firms are hired to pick them up by the Home Office, take them to Stansted and deport them secretly back to Afghanistan because they're no longer children. And a couple of years ago, me and this same group of lawyers, we put injunctions on all the flights, and we led a big campaign and we stopped the flights going to Afghanistan. And I suddenly thought that would be a really good thriller because the kids were actually on the plane, and one by one then the judge said they're not going, and we were like, yeah, we won. So I think the world could do with, like, those kind of, like, we can do it stories and not always just like misery. And I have to say the funniest thing, which is going in this, so this is my feature, the best thing that happened that day is the kids were a bit late to the airport, and we never knew why, but it gave us time to get them, you know, through the court, the night court, to get them off the plane. And I said to her a few days later, "What do you know what happened? Like, some of the kids from detention arrived very late for the flight." And she said, "Oh, I super glued myself to the windscreen of the bus." And I just think that image of this girl. So my next film is going to be a thriller, and just to kind of say, this is what we can all do when we try.
Great.
Thank you for watching The Fan Carpet. If you like this video, be sure to click that thumbs up button at the bottom of your screen. And also be sure to subscribe to The Fan Carpet YouTube channels. They're absolutely free and so much fun too. Be sure to check out the official website, thefancarpet.com. Also, you can follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram to stay up to date with reviews, competitions, the latest news, and so much more.